Hello learners, in this lecture we will see how the airport layout has to be done, and we'll also try to see what are different types of airport layout. So every airport should have a layout showing the ultimate development, even though the construction is to be in the stages, right? So even before we start, as I mentioned, we need to have a complete layout of an airport, even though we try to do the construction in the stages. Such a plan is desirable to ensure an orderly development and an economical and a functionally sound airport. The proper airport layout provides full efficiency with minimum space utilization. An engineer should attempt to provide the simplest design which yields the optimum service to the air passengers. So you can see this is a type of a layout what I have put here. This is the control towers, right? And this is the landing runway, and there are other terminal areas and all. Yeah, so again you can see it's a runway here, then we have aircraft maintenance, then we have taxiway here, and this is the terminal area and all other things. Yeah, so the layout of an airport is dependent upon the number of factors. So what all factors are those? First is number and orientation of the runways. This we'll try to see what are different ways of orientation of the runways in the next module. Next is number of taxiways, size and shape of the aprons, the area and the shape of available land, topography and the site soil condition, right? What is the soil? What is the nature of the soil and all? Obstacles to the air navigation, required proximity of land users within the airport boundaries, surrounding land users, timing and scale of phased development of the airport, meteorology, and size and scale of airport facilities being planned. So these are the different factors on which the airport layout depends on. So the next is the characteristics of a well-planned airport. So what are the characteristics of a well-planned airport? The first one is that it grants a maximum functional efficiency with minimum utilization of the space, right? We always need to extract more with the less input. It grants the maximum functional efficiency with the minimum utilization of the space. The second is it has adequate space for the loading of the aprons. It has sufficient terminal buildings facilities. We have seen what is terminal building. So airport should have a sufficient terminal building facilities. It provides excellent control tower visibility. We also seen what is control tower. And whenever you put up a airport, this control tower should be able to look into each and every activity that is happening on the runways. So it should provide an excellent control tower facility. The operations of landing, taxiing, and takeoff of the aircraft are carried out smoothly without interfering with each other. The overall arrangement of the component is such that the future expansion is easily permitted. The runway length and approaches are safe, right? And the shortest taxiway distance from the loading apron to the runway end. And the last is the lowest possible cost of construction. As far as possible, with lowest cost of construction, we need to have a well-planned airport layout. So these are the few characteristics that we need to understand before planning any airport layout. Yeah. So now coming to the typical airport layout, the first one what we can see is a single runway. So how do we understand this? So you can see it here. It's written single runway. So what you can see, you have a runway here. This is only a single runway. Then this is my taxiway. This is a terminal building. And this is the apron here, right? And from here, from the apron through the taxiway, the aircraft will go. And from here, the takeoff is going to happen, right? So this is a hangar here. So this is single runway. You can see it here, right? It's only one runway. And surrounding to this, we have all those taxiway and all other things. So you can see it here as well. With one flight in 65 seconds, Mumbai becomes the world's busiest single runway airport. So even this airport, what we have, it's a single runway airport, what we have, right? Yeah. So the next one, what we have is a parallel, two parallel runways. So here what will happen, it's again the same thing. We have one runway here, and then there is another runway here. So they are parallel runways. And in between, we have this terminal building. Next, adjacent to the terminal building, we have one apron here. Then we have another apron here, right? And then we have another apron in this position. And this is a hangar for the maintenance and all, right? And we have one runway and the other runway here. The same thing you can see here. You have one runway here and there is another runway here. The Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, what we have in Hyderabad, they have the two parallel runway system there, right? Yeah. And the next one, what we have is the three non-intersecting runway. That means you have one runway here, which are non-intersecting. Then we have another one runway here. Then there's another runway here. In between this, we have a terminal building here. And for that, we have this taxiway so that your aircraft can come. And from here, the takeoff is going to happen or the landing will happen. And here we have this apron. And here also we have a taxiway. We have a taxiway and we have a taxiway here. So this is the three non-intersecting runway. They are not intersecting anyway. It's a non-intersecting runway. And the last one, what we have is the tangential runways. So in between we have an apron here. And all these are the runways what we have, right? So all these are the runways what we have. And then we have a terminal building in the center. And this is surrounding to that we have aprons, because through aprons only the aircraft will go to the runways, right? Yeah. And this is a circular apron area. And in this portion, they are given a hangar area for the maintenance of the aircraft and all. So this is a hangar area. So this is how the airport layout is done. So first one is a single runway. The second one we had a parallel. Then we have not non-intersecting. And the fourth one, what we have is a tangential runways. So I hope you got an idea regarding the airport layout and the different airport layout what we have, like the single runway, the parallel and all. So in the next lecture, we'll try to see what are the different site investigations for the airport and what is the best location for the airport. How do we decide the location of airport in the next lecture? So we'll see you back in the next lecture. Thank you.